Good morning, kings and queens. This is Beyond the Walls Ministry, and I'm your minister, TJ Beatty. This morning, our scripture will be coming from Romans chapter 8, verses 5 and 6. And it reads, those who are dominated by the sinful nature think about sinful things. But those who are controlled by the Holy Spirit think about things that please the Spirit. So letting your sinful nature control your mind leads to death. But letting the Spirit control your mind leads to life and peace. I ask you the question of today, where is your mind? Where are you going in life? What are you planning to do with yourself? What are you engulfed in? What does your daily life look like? How do you know that you're going to be pleasing to God on today? Or how do you know if you're going to be pleasing to the enemy? What are you doing? What is your focus? Who are you connected to? What is your plan each day to make sure that you stay aligned with the Word of God? How do you implement the Word of God into your life as you go day by day? How do you practice what the Word of God teaches so that you can be an example, a living image of Christ, a shining light of who He needs you to be in and out of places that the enemy may be trying to be? How do you go into those places and still bring the presence of God with you? Or is your mind so entangled, so dominated by the enemy that everything that you think about is a sinful nature? If your mind is waking up about drinking, waking up about smoking, thinking about partying, thinking about having sex, you're not married and you're having sex out here with someone. If you're thinking about pimping every woman that's walking around on the streets. If you think about selling drugs to make a profit, a living. If you're thinking about hurting people, causing harm, stealing, robbing, doing things that are not what God would have you do, then those things, that means that, guess what? Your mind has been taken over by the enemy. He comes to kill, steal, and destroy, and you're all a part of his plan if everything that you do is leading to that sinful nature. That sinful nature. When you think about a sinful nature, something being dominated, this means that this is something that you do every day. That means that this is your habitat. This is something that you've become accustomed to. When it's a sinful nature, it means that you wake up, that your mind is engulfed in these things. If your mind is all about how can I cause harm to another person? Sometimes, guess what? You can be so engulfed in the sinful nature that even when you're not even waking up thinking about, hey, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that, that's negative. But guess what? You do it. You get to work, guess what you do? You sleep on the clock. You get to work, guess what? You're stealing time. You get to work, you're stealing out of the office. You get to work, you're doing everything. Guess what? You're not being that man of God you need to be. You see that woman at work, guess what you're doing? You're trying to get a number, have sex with her. Those things are the sinful nature. But it says that, but those who are controlled by the Holy Spirit think about things that please the Spirit. The mindset. Let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. I'm trying to please the Spirit. Who I am, guess what? It's loving. It's caring. It's forgiving. It's understanding. It's a person who has the mindset, guess what? I'm going to treat others how I want to be treated. How I want to be treated is how God treats me. So guess what? When I see my neighbors, I'm going to be kind to them. I'll be polite to them. I'll treat them right. But those who are controlled by the Holy Spirit think about things that please the Spirit. Watch it right here. You see the key words. Those who are controlled by the Spirit, what they do? They think about things that please the Spirit. Father, what can I do today? How can I be your example on today, God? How can I love my kids more on today, God? How can I love my wife on today, God? How can I be a better father, a better husband? How can I be a better neighbor? How can I be a better coworker? How can I be a leader on today? What can I do to be an example on today? How can I help someone on today? I'm thinking about things that will please the Spirit. Father God, on today, I want to be more in your words today. God, what spirit, what scriptures will you lead me to on today, God? so that I can be the man of God that you call me to be, so that I can be prepared, God, that when I'm out in this world, if I come across on people that are lost, God, that I can give them a word on today, God. Or if I come across, if the enemy tries to come into my life on today, God, how I can have faith and stand strong on your word on today. I'm thinking about things that would please the spirit. So letting your sinful nature control your mind leads to death. Yes, you should probably say, well, everybody has to die. That is true. But there's a death that you will experience because of the sinful nature that the one who is living of the Spirit and the Holy Spirit who is living for God, who is pleasing God, will never experience. That death that you will experience will be one of torment, one of fire, one of discomfort. That is one that you will experience. That death that you will experience. Guess what? Also, the death that you will experience will be a death that you will be living on this earth as well. It'll be a life that you will be leading daily. Guess what? When you say you don't never experience the blessings of God, you never experience the peace of God, you never get the understanding, you never get any of those things because you are pleasing the enemy. Everything that you're doing, you're killing your soul, the soul of man. You're killing the spirit man. You're killing the flesh. You're killing everything about yourself because guess what? You are living to only please the enemy. So letting your sinful nature control your mind leads to death. I encourage you today, if you're living that life, you're living lost, you're living in turmoil, you're living in hurt, you're living in pain, you're living this in disappointment, you're living in disagreement, I encourage you on today, get your life right with God, to go and start living for Christ. Start change your mind on today. Start talking to God on today. Pick up the Word of God, the 66 books, and start seeking the God, seeking God so you can know Him on today, so that you can have a relationship with Him on today. So letting your sinful nature control your mind leads to death, but letting the Spirit control your mind leads to life in peace. That's the mind that you want. You want to be living for Christ so that you can have a mind of peace. You want a life that is full of peace. My grandma always talk about that joy and that peace, but that was that mindset that she was able to have, being able to get up every day and have a peace of mind. Having a peace of mind, because the reason she had that peace of mind, because she know that she was living for Christ. She knew that she was living to please Christ daily. She knew that she was living to be His example daily. She knew that she was living for Him. So there was nothing going to change her mind. Nothing that was going to stop her from being a woman of God. So I'm asking you on today, are you living that mind, that life today on today? Are you rooted? Has your foundation been set that everything that you do is to please the Spirit? Or is it that everything that you do is building a foundation to please the enemy? I encourage you on today, take the time today to restore, to repair, and renew the relationship with Christ on today, so that your life can be filled with joy, can be filled with love, can be filled with peace, can be filled with understanding, can be filled with blessings. This is an opportunity for you on today. Where are you going on today? What is your mindset on today? Think about that. Hey guys, I know there's somebody out there on today that may be lost, may be needing a new life with Christ, maybe needing to God to come in to change what they got going on in their everyday life so they can be closer to Him and live closer with Him. If that's you on today, I ask that you say this prayer with me on today. If that's you on today, say this simple prayer with me. Dear God, you are my Father and I'm your child. I believe that your Son, Jesus Christ, died but rose the third day with all power in His hand. If you said that on today, I believe that you are saved on today. I believe that God's Spirit will be with you, that you now can walk in the life of love. You can now walk in the life of joy. You can now walk in the spirit of peace and truth. I believe that on today. And I believe that there's somebody out there on today that may be dealing with some things that maybe need prayer. You may be wanting to intercede for a family member or a friend that needs prayer on today. Well, this is the time. And I want to pray for them as well. Most gracious eternal Father God, we love you on today, God. We praise you on today, God. God, we know that you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords, God. We know that you are Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shalom, God. You are a name above all names, God. You're one that we can call on at any time, God. And right now we call on you, God, the mighty, powerful God. We seek you on today, God. We ask that you come into our lives, God, that you touch us, God, that you strengthen us, God. You help us to endure on today, God. God, give us the mindset, Lord God, that you have, God. God, we know this is not robbery, God, to take on your mindset, God. And God, we seek that on today, God, so that we can endure through the tough times, God. So when the enemy tries to step into our planes of life, God, that we can continue to tumble over him, God, because we trust you, God. Knowing, God, that you have all power in your hands, God. Knowing that we are victorious with you, God. Knowing, God, that you can do anything but fail, God. God, so we thank you, God. We praise you, God. We know that on today, God, you are touching the lives, God. You're sending your angels, God, to and fro, God, to go into many places, God, the highways and byways, to be with us, God, to give us protection, to give us guidance, God, to give us leadership, to give us understanding, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we thank you right now, God, for what you are doing, God. Lord, we love you on today, God, and we praise you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Hey, guys. Hey, I love you guys. I thank you guys for tuning in again here with us on Beyond the Walls Ministry. Hey, guys, be blessed. We love you.